Action Sports Jacks Friday Night Blitz. Sponsored by Whataburger. Just like you like it.
All we must do now is grab that helmet with that spear and put it on our head and run out. And when my best is required, I show them exactly who we are.
Oh, it is a new era in Folkestone, Georgia. DeMario Jones giving his first pregame pep talk to the Indians as they get things started tonight, and so do we. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Friday Night Blitz. It is a new season, and we have never been this fired up, for a high school football season.
Right. Brand new network. Yeah, that's the Action Sports Shack's 24/7 network. Not this. Fox 30's been around for a while. But more programming than ever before. And in a couple of weeks, that will happen. I'm Brett Martineau. He's Stuart Weber.
Yeah, tonight, a week zero edition of the Blitz. Some games count more than in past years, by the way.
Yeah.
Some games don't count. Next week, the regular season underway for everybody. But for tonight, how about we give you a little bonus game of the week?
The game of the week, sponsored by Whataburger.
And we are headed back up to Folkestone. Coach Jones and the Indians ready for their maiden voyage. First up, the Brantley County Herons. The Herons. First offensive series of the season ends in a touchdown. Amari Wilson, direct snap along the right edge and in. It's 7-0 early on. Ensuing possession. What do we got there? Brandon with the first defensive turnover of the season. Snags the interception. Charlton County back on offense. Then Indians convert a fourth down in the red zone the best way possible. Aiden Cruz connects with Wilson. Short pass goes the distance. Home team up 14-0 at that point. Indians defense came ready to hunt tonight. Eli Hobbs coming up with a fumble recovery for the defense. Indians would go on to score. They would lead 28-0 at one point. Home team gets the win 61-13. Marcel Robinson has more on the faces of the Southeast Georgia sidelines.
It'll be a new era for two of our prestigious schools up here in South Georgia. Of course, we're talking about the Charlton County Indians and the Camden County Wildcats. We'll talk with the Charlton County Indians. They're starting a new era with the new head coach, DeMario Jones, who came over from Tallahassee Godby after spending a little bit of time there. By the way, Reigns grad, so technically one of our Jacksonville locals is now up here in Georgia coaching the Charlton County Indians. Jeff's up the road in Camden County. Well, in Kingsland, Jeff Heron stepped down not long ago, a guy that brought state championships and a lot of history to the Wildcats. They're going into a new era with another guy who just brought a championship to Malin. Of course, I'm talking about Travis Rowland. The Malin native decided that he's going to cross the border from Florida and come up here into Georgia, which seems to be a bit of a trend. But nonetheless, these are two guys who are starting a new program and a new start in a new season, both coming off wins, so can't ask for a better debut. That's the story here up here in Charlton County, Georgia. I'm Marcel Robinson, Action Sports Jacks.
Continued up in Georgia, a good matchup between Camden County and Brunswick, and the Pirates from Brunswick started fast. Nigel Gardner makes a simple play look extraordinary. Runs away from everybody. 65-yard touchdown run. Pirates get on the board first. Come the Camden County Wildcats on the goal line. Some play action. Watch as Parks Riendu tosses into the end zone to the big fella, Elias Williams, 6'7", 240 pounds. He scooped it off the turf for a touchdown. More Pirates coming up a little bit after that. It took a while to signal a touchdown, but it was a touchdown. Nice touch pass coming up here from two William Hicks. Got it over the defender. And once he catches it, free to the end zone. This game's still going on in the fourth.
At last check in the fourth, Camden County leading it 51-34. So no shortage of points in the opener.
Plenty of highlights. They'll be playing until midnight.
Two teams. Yeah, they very well may be. And welcome out to the wall here as we take a look at our game of the week schedule. This thing is ready to go for the year. Of course, it starts up next week, regular season starting up for the FHSAA. And away we go, Brent.
Yeah, predetermined. We do our game of the week that way, but we're going to have a handful of games of the week.
It's going to be a little different this year.
Little hint, you'll see more of that coming up in just a little bit. But we try to spread the wealth a little bit, get out to other areas and counties and states. Not others, just Florida,
just
Georgia.
Just the one other state where we go to Ware County there in week three.
How about this? Just if you want to know how good some of the games of the week are, look at the first 2 weeks. Ooh. I mean, Bradford, Baker County, the storylines are terrific. And then Bowles, Trinity Christian in week two. I mean, you can keep going. But just take an early peek at the next two.
I'm excited for the Surf and Turf Bowl.
Surf and Turf Bowl.
I just love the name. I love the Surf and Turf Bowl. Two of our newest schools, a little Surf and Turf. That'll be a whole lot of fun. But, exciting stuff. And, you know, week five, we've got St. Augustine at home. That'll be a big game for them, a military appreciation game. So yes, some pretty cool things happening. And speaking of the Jackets, St. Augustine going against the Orange Park Raiders in their kickoff classic. And you've likely heard of this combo before for the Mustangs. Tremel Jones, Jamie French, first touchdown of the game, first touchdown of the season, although this one doesn't count. Does have to work on the celebration, though. You got to unsportsmanlike conduct. So, you know, 15.
It seemed like it was worth it.
Yeah, maybe. Was that a sprinkler move? I don't know. Still in the first, Tremel spreading the love to Shanquise Foster for six. Mandarin led 12-0 at that point. Then Jones, and this is a big play, 53-yarder to Cameron Mills. Off he goes. Number nine takes it to the house. Look, Mandarin starters, they were impressive, and that's what these kickoff classics are about. You get the starters out there, you get them in rhythm, and you see where it goes from there. So Mandarin starters dominate. And speaking of Mandarin starters,
they got a couple good ones.
They got some good ones.
They've got a lot of good ones. Yeah, they've got so much firepower now, so much talent. Safety Drake Stubbs joins Jamie French as a five-star. Stubbs was a four-star, just ticked up recently. So that's a big deal to the kids, of course. The Mandarin Mustangs, I don't even think it's a conversation. They have the most talent in the area. Action Sports Shaq's Olivia Tassley has more tonight on the Mustangs and that dynamic duo.
Well, the preseason isn't supposed to be perfect, right? This is where coaches and players learn what they need to tweak before the regular season, where everything starts to count. Well, the state runner-ups won't be tweaking much after putting more than 50 points up against this Orange Park Raiders team. I actually spoke with head coach Toby Bullock ahead of the first whistle, asking him about two of his star players, and that's QB Tremel Jones and, of course, his favorite wide receiver in Jamie French. And he says, you know what, I'm not as excited this season about these guys because I know it's their last season suiting up in the orange and green, but of course he is excited to see where these guys and what these guys do in the collegiate level. I'm gonna throw my name at you. That is Shanquise Foster. He was my MVP for tonight after multiple touchdowns for the Mustangs, including the first successful two-point conversions for this Mandarin team. And then how about this defense? A shutout game for against the Raiders. That will be a matchup the offenses in Northeast Florida need to look for. Well, that'll do it here at Orange Park High School. For now, I'm Olivia Tassley, Action Sports Jax.
Olivia on Twitter, star of Jax Social, by the way. You can follow her every Friday night at Olivia A.S. Jax. Fernandina Beach hosting Zarephath. Sully the Pirate getting everyone riled. SSAA. So this game counts, I guess.
That's cool.
Yeah. Fernandina would strike first, but it all went downhill after Fernandina's senior quarterback had to leave the game with a leg injury. Zarephath had not one but two pick sixes. First from T.J. Brandt, and the second would be from Daryl Banks. Ooh. Jumped in front of that one, didn't he? Went a long way. Eagles win big, 48-14. Get the job done. Pirates new to the SSAA. Action Sports Shaq's Jason Hamby there tonight and explaining a little bit about the new conference.
It's a regular season open here at Fernandina Beach, taking on Zarephath tonight. Guys, both these teams members of the SSAA. I spoke with the Fernandina Beach athletic director earlier tonight, just saying just had high praises for this organization, SSAA, and how it really gives teams a chance to rebuild. You know, he said four coaches in 7 years for Fernandina Beach. It's really given them a chance to reset so they can go forward and chance of rejoining the FHSAA when this two-year cycle is over. Also mentioned the big thing here is it's a guaranteed playoff game, obviously, for all teams. He said there was about 25 teams in football teams in this organization last year, now 95, close to 100 this year. So a lot of teams migrating over, trying to get this guaranteed playoff game, and obviously their season starts tonight. I'm Jason Hamby, Action Sports Shaq.
Yeah, that is one of the cool things is they set up these brackets and you play teams of a like to yourself. Yeah. Let's join this game at the half. We got West Nassau at Paxson and the Warriors into the end zone there. 2 minutes left in the third when Skylar Freeman takes it. Two-point conversion good. 20-14 West Nassau. Paxson looks to answer. A.J. Davis fakes the handoff, evades the defender, and into the end zone. And the Golden Eagles regain the lead. All right, late fourth. West Nassau trying to win it from the one. Fourth and one. 20 seconds to go. Price Arnold looking for the sneak, but instead turned away at the goal line. That's a turnover on downs. The clock goes to zero. Defensive stand by Paxson wins the game 22-20, your final score over West Nassau. Nice win for Paxson.
Yeah, Arnold tried everything to get
that counts,
in the end zone.
By the way, because it was an SSAA game.
That was the game of the night. Yeah. Commanders of Ed White playing host to Andrew Jackson to get this thing started. First Ed White possession and driving. Tavion Lawson steps in front of it and takes it to the house. Andrew Jackson ahead 7-0 just like that. So a big defensive play for the Tigers. Next Ed White drive. After a little celebration. Gonna throw it up top. And who's gonna come down with it? Oh, Lawson again? Put him up for maybe a little player of the week nominee.
Oh.
Next week. When we start that. After a drop punt attempt, Ed White's in range when Joseph Williams punches this one in. 2-point attempt, good. Ed White takes an 8-7 lead in the first, so they rebounded nicely. The Commanders never look back. They cruised to a 44-7 win.
They bounced back really nicely.
I guess they did after that rough start.
Hey, shout out to all the fans, not just the ones here in Ponte Vedra. Get some dance moves. Is he flossing?
What?
He's flossing.
He's flossing.
A little floss.
I didn't know anybody still flossed.
But you know what? Shout out to the fans that come out for the Kickoff Classics, because those are the diehards. They're the family members. And you know what? They're here to support the community, and you love to see that.
I was at a game. That was a great crowd.
Yeah, good crowd there. All right, let's check out the highlights for it. Ponte Vedra playing host to St. Augustine, another one of those really good teams in the area with talented players like this guy, number 11, Lachlan Hewlett, rolls out to his left, finds Samarion Wingo. How about that catch on the sideline? Gets the foot in. That's a big gainer. A little later in the drive, it's the same, too. This catch, not as impressive. A little dump off in the flat, but this one goes for six, so you like to see it. Strike a pose, young man. More from the Jackets. This is Nate Preston busting through and across the goal line he goes for a touchdown run. St. Augustine, one of those teams looking to repeat their run from a year ago, made it all the way to the state championship game with an undefeated regular season.
So St. Augustine, Mandarin, Rains, Bowles, definitely near the top of everyone's power pole if you do one of those. Hard to argue going into this season. Really good.
Absolutely. All right, hey, more action from the opening night of high school ball and more explaining to do. It is the week zero, so you know we're getting you set for the season to come, and we got new districts to talk about again. I feel like every 2 years we're going to come up with a new idea, and we're going back to an old idea this time. We have that coming up on the Friday Night Blitz.
We are the Corey Toros, and you're watching Friday Night Blitz. Yeah!
When I say it means something to me, gentlemen, it means something to me.
High school football is back, and it's bigger than ever. Welcome to the Friday Night Zone Blitz.
It is bigger than a game.
Watch the biggest games each week live as the action unfolds with instant reaction and analysis from our Hall of Famer, Kevin Sullivan. It starts with live look-ins at the top matchups, including our Jaguars Prep Whataburger Game of the Week. And that is just the beginning of four straight hours of coverage. From 8 to 10:30, the Friday Night Zone Blitz is streaming on our Action News Jax app and online. At 10:30, the Friday Night Blitz you know and love. A half hour of highlights from around the area. 11 o'clock, we shine the spotlight on the bands that pump up the crowd. 11:15, it's time to blitz through the highlights online and on air. Then 11:35, back to the stream to break down the night's results with a reaction from local coaches. Four straight hours of high school football on the Friday Night Zone Blitz. Only on Action Sports Jax 24/7.
This is Action Sports Jack's Friday Night Blitz, sponsored by Whataburger, just like you like it.
Everyone can't wait to get to play in a state championship in, well, we don't know.
I don't know, man.
Don't book your reservations to nowhere just yet. The FHSAA didn't decide on Tallahassee last year, you said, until September.
September.
So we're thinking there will be a decision soon. Who knows? As long as they know by late November when the teams have
to. They might split it again. I don't know. Last year was all Tallahassee. The year before was half Tallahassee, half Miami. And now that we're back to the normal classifications, it might be some games. Because Miami, you get good crowds from the Miami schools that often make it to the state title games. It's a whole.
How about we just play it at Hodges Stadium and call it a day?
That'd be good.
Easy coverage
for
us.
We're up for it, right?
It's all about trying to win a state championship. Welcome back, everybody, to the Friday Night Blitz 2024.
Yeah, we have so many good football players, coaches, and programs in this area, but winning a title, really hard to do, and getting there is just a shade easier than winning it all. So close last year for three area teams. Bradford, St. Augustine, Mandarin, all getting that chance to play in Tallahassee. which I thought, by the way, as a venue, I thought Bragg Memorial Stadium on the campus of FAMU was appropriately sized. The speakers were too loud in the video board. But other than that, I thought it was a good venue to hold a state championship game in.
Yeah. Maybe they'll do it again.
Maybe they will. It's very possible that they will. So the quest to hold that trophy is, it's tough as you try to put your name in the history books of high school football.
We have a lot of kids who've been, you know, they're three-year starters that took a lot of lumps when they were sophomores, and last year had a little more success, and then, you know, have high expectations for themselves this year. And it's been a unique year in that last year there was a lot of anticipation for our guys, and we really had some high emotion senior guys on that team. And the demeanor of this year's senior class is just a little more reserved. They're great kids. They work really hard. They're really talented. So it's a different team, but it's a lot of fun.
Can you match last year or can you beat last year? That's what the Mustangs are trying to do.
That's definitely the goal, to beat it. I think we can. I think, you know, you got to have luck in the game of football. You got to stay healthy, most of all. But I definitely think we can. I think we have the talent to do it. I think, I know we have the coaches to do it.
You've had, obviously, a lot of wins. Like, is the town still buzzing about what's about to come here in these next few weeks? And just give us a sense of it.
Yeah, I think they're more excited now than they have been. I think it kind of snuck up on them. I'll be honest with you, it snuck up on me. When I watched the film when I took the job, I knew they had talent. I knew the guys could run around. I knew that the physicality wasn't a problem. But I didn't expect, 26-3 over the last couple of years. I didn't see that coming. And I don't think the town did either. And now that's kind of the expectation.
Oh, high expectations in those places that we mentioned. High expectations all across the board.
Yep.
And here we go again. It's the reason. It's really not just the reason. I mean, we would have Stuart Weber on the show anyway.
Yeah.
But when it's time to dissect and explain whatever the FHSAA did next, I stay out of that game. Here comes Weber.
All right.
On the wall that says it all.
So you might remember last 2 years we did the Metro Suburban thing.
We do. We were just starting to figure it out.
Just figured it out. We split the top eight counties into their own half of the state, and the rest of the counties in the state had all the other classifications. Well, we scrapped that. We got rid of it. We've gone back to the old way. It goes from 7A all the way down to 1A, plus a rural classification as well. So you get some of these same old rivalries back on the schedule this year. You look at some of the bigger classifications, Mandarin sharing a district with Oakleaf, for example. How about Creekside gets to join in there with Sandalwood and Atlantic Coast? And
small district.
Small district, three schools. So one of those three is going to win a district title.
This district's insane.
Yeah.
That's hard.
Look, there's some tough districts. I mean, look at 3-6A.
Yeah,
if you're Nice or Tocoy, you got Bartram and Buchholz right there staring at you. So it creates some of these good rivalries from across county borders that maybe we missed when Duval was sent to Metro instead of Suburban. But here we are.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, listen, I've learned this about the FHSA. Some are going to like it and some are not. That's just the way it goes. Indeed. Let's go to Englewood. Maybe you'll like this. The Rams hosting the Yulee Hornets. Yulee brought a big crowd in the band and the mascot for the Kickoff Classic. Speaking of kickoffs, or punts. They brought some game, too. Special teams always interesting early in the year. Turtle Ricks, number 52, breaks through, blocks it. Joe Almanord recovers it for the Hornets. They're in business. Couldn't cash in right away because big Keith Forbes for the Englewood Rams. There he is. Tackle for a loss. A few plays later, Yulee Shamar Gibbs tries to avoid that big fella, and he does. Easy touchdown. Yulee was looking good in the first half under Coach Doherty, so a nice start. For the Hornets.
All right, let's go to the Shipyard, shall we? First Coast hosting the Rebolt Trojans, and Rebolt moving the ball early. Jaden Miller throwing. And that's a big gainer there for Rebolt, but they were unable to turn it into points.
All right, I got names here.
You got
Mike
names?
Hill
okay.
to Denzel Brown.
Like that. We like names. Names are good. That would set up a touchdown run by...
I'm out of names.
Oh, come on. You teased me with names and then...
I asked for four names.
All right.
And Barnes gave me two.
Shout out to 13. Touchdown run there. And then we get a little two-point conversion. Okay, good catch
there
in the end zone.
Come on, First Coast. Put your names in Mac Preps.
Yeah, got to get Mac Preps updated. All right, speaking of First Coast...
No. We fumble the punt.
Oh, okay.
You know, and then y'all get the ball back.
Yeah,
we've got to stop them. if we stop them, we can win this ball game.
Right, right. And we run like counter pass, tight end on the corner, and their kids all by none. It was like fourth and five.
It was fourth and five.
From about the 15 going in, and we run the pass, and we hit the guy in the end zone. And score, and I look across the field, and Marty's giving me double birds across the field.
Listen, you're watching high school football, which means you like high school football.
Yes.
If you like high school football, if you like coaching, if you want to get into coaching, please watch this show. We're not even on it. You saw Josh Baker and Kevin Sullivan and different coaches. It's really fun. Listen. And you can check it out on our Action Sports Shacks 24/7 network Tuesdays and Fridays. You can also check it out on our YouTube channel. There's a playlist with all our guests so far.
The Coach of the Week, sponsored by Whataburger.
So all fall, once again this year, Whataburger, Jaguars, Prep, and the Friday Night Blitz will recognize area coaches as our Coach of the Week. That starts up next week. Last year, more than $15,000 given to support local high school football programs. And St. Augustine's Brian Braddock, our Coach of the Year a season ago, he and his wife got to go to Vegas for the Super Bowl, courtesy of the Jaguars and the NFL.
Well, a local quarterback legend will play inside Everbank Stadium tomorrow night for the first time in his life. How about that? And he'll do it against another Jacksonville QB legend. That story coming up next.
We are Fletcher Senators, and you are watching Friday Night Blitz.
Let's go, man. Let's go!
The Player of the Week, sponsored by Whataburger.
Well, we mentioned earlier Jaguars Prep, Whataburger, and the Friday Night Blitz recognizing the coaches. That will be done for the Players of the Week as well. Each week there will be a vote. You have to nominate players. There will be a couple of days to vote, and then an area player honored. Last year's Player of the Year was Mandarin running back Teont White.
They do a good job honoring them at the games as well. As you can see, they got a chance to go out on the field.
Including tomorrow night, by the way.
Yeah.
They're going to have 4,000 tickets handed out to local, to the local community.
We'll be out on the field as well because we got Countdown to Kickoff coming up. Bucks, Jags, 7:30 on CBS 47 with Countdown to Kickoff at 7. Post-game afterwards. And we're going to see a lot of Johnny Wolford in that one. So excited.
And Mac Jones.
See it. And Mac Jones, who has only played in the bank once, and that was Little Gator Bowl.
Yeah, back
a long time ago.
Pretty cool.
All right, Player of the Week.
All right, here we go, man. Goal line stand for our first player of the week.
I love it.
How about that?
Paxson's Alfred Jokang. That's number 25, ripping the QB off the pile and making sure he doesn't get across. So shout out to him right there. And
we were watching that live, and you will be able to watch games and finishes like that live starting in a couple weeks with our new Zone Blitz starting 8 p.m. on Action Sports Shack's 24/7 network.
All right, that's it. Thanks so much for watching.
Thanks for watching Action Sports Jack's Friday Night Blitz, sponsored by Whataburger, just like you like it.